Hello everyone, Roy Kerckhoffs here. It's a little bit of a dreary day in Carlsbad today. So it's a perfect day to do some hand coloring. Today I'm going to work on this 39 International, which I shot a couple of years ago. And I'm going to color it with my Rembrandt pastels. As you can see, I haven't used them very much yet. Actually, this is maybe only my fourth piece which I'm going to color with these pastels. And I'm going to put the color on with cotton rounds, Q-tips, and if I need them, I'm not sure yet, ITs, which are very pointy Q-tips for the very detailed work. I printed this with my inkjet printer on, this is 12 mil, 230 grams per square meter matte paper. So this is not really photo paper. Which is actually perfect to use pastels on them. Okay, so let's get started. What I like to do normally when I work with pastels is to put these pastels on an extra piece of paper like this one. Well, it's actually a piece of foam core used in my own artwork. And then I'll take a Q-tip and pick it up. Then I'm going to rub that onto the photo. You can put the pastels directly on the photo too. But you have to use very little pressure, and I will do that later on. If you put it on too thick, you cannot remove it anymore from the paper. With a Q-tip like this, you can put it on very thin and very subtly. When I work with Marshall photo oils on matte photo paper, I put the paint on and then it's okay to go over the lines because you can easily remove that paint later, even after a few days. And usually I do that with Q-tips also. So when I work with oils, I put it on very roughly, and I don't mind if I go over the lines. However, in this case, you have to do it right the first time. It's not easy, if at all, to remove the pastels from the paper. Here I try not to go over the lines. You can also mix the pastel colors, just like with oils. I'm going to add a little orange onto the burnt sienna later on, and also some yellows where the sun is shining on these areas. Thank you. This 1939 International truck is located at Bungalow in the Boulders in Joshua Tree in California. That is, it's in the outskirts of the town of Joshua Tree. The owner is a collector of old cars, trucks, neon signs, and all kinds of classic paraphernalia, and puts this on his 5-acre property. Still working with the same color here, and I'll do that for a while. I would like to put on this base color everywhere on the truck first. The cool thing about pastels as opposed to the Marshall photo oils is that you can put the pastels on the paper ranging from transparent to completely opaque. It's only a matter of how hard you push. When you use the pastels directly on the paper, you can get it opaque more easily as opposed to using Q-tips. I don't want to put too much pastel on the darker regions, as I like to keep those dark and black. I like to conserve the contrast in my images. If you don't push too hard, you can still remove pastels from those regions if you accidentally do go over it. When the size of the Q-tip gets too flat, I'll take a new one. Sometimes I completely make up the colors from my photos, but in this case I'm kind of coloring the scene as what it really looked like. You cannot use pastels on matte photo paper, as the paper needs to have some tooth to it, like this one. This is paper that you can draw on with pencils and pastels. I could have used the cotton rounds for the grid on the front here, but then I also would have put pastel colors between the grid, and too much color would have been added to these dark regions. I'm adding the color very softly here, as the sun is directly shining on this part. Now I'm going to add the pastel directly to the bumper, but I'm still not pushing very hard at all. And this part here, I'm adding some pastel color in an opaque manner, as you can see, pushing much harder on the pastel. See how non-uniform the pastel shows on the bumper? I will smooth that out with a Q-tip. I have mounted this photo on a stiff gator board to give it some support. And now I smooth out this region. Thank you. Let's use a cotton round here because the area is pretty large. On the edges here, I'll use a Q-tip again, just to be a little bit more careful. When you add too much color to a very light region, like here, it can look a little bit odd. To fix that, you can make it lighter again by using a white pastel. It's subtle, but it's there. Same thing, when you add too much color to a darker region, as here, you can change that too by adding black. That looks pretty good. Let's start adding some different colors now. I'm thinking of an orange. So let's add some orange to the bottom of the lights here. Here, let's put it on directly again, not pushing too hard. I will still smooth that out too with a Q-tip. The image has already quite transformed now. It looks so much different from when it was completely black and white. The image already looked quite interesting when it was uncolored, but coloring it this way just adds that personal touch to it. And, like I mentioned before, you don't have to go with the colors of the original scene. You can completely make this up, take it in your own hands. I'm adding some yellow ochre here to the regions where the sun is shining on. Now I'm going to add a little bit of blue to the windshield and the top of the lights. That warm, cool contrast usually works nicely. Thank you. Let's add some yellow to the letters and numbers of this classic license plate. Dabbing the color on here. This photo is not very large, it's only 15 by 10 inches, so the details are a little bit harder to work on, like these numbers of the license plate. I would like to have this color a little more saturated, so I'm using a pastel directly on the paper. This pastel has a pointy side, so it's good for detail. That looks good. Now I'm removing some of the color from the black regions. This is where the ITs come in. I can use these very pointy Q-tips to remove the color from the inside of the numbers. I'm thinking I should add some color to the background too. So I will add some very light brown to the landscape and the back using cotton rounds. and on this side. I'll put darker brown on the front, still very thin, adding it with a cotton round. And I will add some blue to the darker regions in the clouds over here. windshield has a little bit too much blue for my taste, and you can see I cannot rub it off anymore, so I will add some white to this area. And blend that white into the blues underneath with a Q-tip. A little more. I'm using another clean Q-tip. And we're done. It does need to be fixated, so later I will add a varnish spray. It won't need too much spray, as most of the pastel is pushed into the paper. You can see it rubs off a little bit. And since I'm also going to frame this piece, I will also put some glass over it for some extra protection.